Greetings. This series has been a struggle for multiple reasons. I do not want to conflate the gospel with politics, and more specifically, American politics. Even though there is a clear side of the spectrum operating by deception. But even as I write that, I'm corrected in my thinking, in my heart. Is it a lie to repeat false information when you think the false information is true? I would have to argue no. It is not a lie when one repeats false information while thinking it is true. In fact, I have made that point many times in videos through the past 15 years. A Muslim is not a liar when they repeat Islamic claims they believe to be true. But a Muslim who knows he is repeating provably false information is, by definition, a liar. Remove the word Muslim, and the definition applies to all mankind. A person is not a liar when they repeat false claims they believe to be true. This is important, especially when one considers the definition of delusion, and in the context of the strong delusion. From the Cambridge Dictionary, delusion, something a person believes and wants to be true when it is actually not true. Delusion is not the false thing that is believed. It is the state or condition of believing the false information. So let's draw a little picture about the types of people. Let's begin with information. It's either true or false. The first problem one might have is college conditioning of a post-truth reality. Utter rubbish. Often oversimplified into the soundbite phrase, there is no truth. But that claim is self-defeating by one simple question. Is that true? If it is true, then it disproves itself by contradiction. And I have covered the infinite regression before. If it is false, then the claim it makes is false, and there is truth. Are true statements. There is true information. So we are left to consider true and false information. People under delusion believe false information, but think it is true. They exist under a damning confusion of false information they think is true. People who are liars know information is false, but claim it is true. They do so to create damning confusion. That is why telling lies is an evil that will be damned. I did not say God will damn, as men damn themselves by their choice. John 3:18. You ever read past John 3:16? It's really very informative. He that believes on him is not condemned, but he that believes not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. In John 8:34, Jesus said, "That is why I told you that you would die in your sins. For unless you believe that I am He, meaning the Son of Man, you will die in your sins. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil." Notice the implication of free will. Love. Men loved darkness. That's a choice to love or not. For everyone that does evil hates the light, neither comes to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. Again, the implication of free will, neither comes. It's a choice to come to the light, and people who commit sins avoid the light. But he that does truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. Again, the implication of free will, intent to come to the light, agency. But even though there are these two groups of people, people under delusion and people who are liars, God does not give us liberty to have aught with them. We must not hate them. Luke 6:27, "But I say to you which hear, love your enemies, do good to them which hate you, bless them that curse you, and pray for them which despitefully use you. And unto him that smites thee on the one cheek, offer also the other. And him that takes away your cloak, forbid not to take thy coat away. Give to every man that asks thee, and of him that takes away thy goods, ask them not again." That's talking about theft. If they steal something from you, don't go after it. This is rubber meets the road time. Right now, Christians are being slaughtered around the world. And with every slaughter, Satan's minions defend Mohammedism. Satan's minions include, but are not limited to, the liars and the deluded. In Stalin's era, they were called Stalin's useful idiots. Our command from our God is to love and pray for, and in a word, forgive, because Jesus shed his blood for the forgiveness of all. Daniel 9:26, "And after 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off, but not for himself." Isaiah 53:8, "He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed or bruised for our iniquities. The punishment or chastisement that brought us peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed." Without question, the Messiah would die to obtain forgiveness for all. John 11:49, "But one of them, named Caiaphas, who was high priest that year, said to them, 'You know nothing at all. You do not realize that it is better for you that one man die for the people than that the whole nation perish.'" His first comment seems a little insensitive, if not insulting. You know nothing at all. But Caiaphas did not say this on his own. Instead, as high priest that year, he was prophesying that Jesus would die for the nation. And not only for the nation. This means Israel. The nation means Israel. But also for the scattered children of God, to gather them together into one. He already mentioned Israel, the Jews. This must therefore mean the Gentiles. On the cross, Jesus exemplified God's love, his agape. Luke 23:34, "Then said Jesus, 'Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.' And they parted his raiment and cast lots." Please forgive them. And we have Stephen's example to consider and emulate. Acts 7, verse 60. "Falling on his knees, he cried out in a loud voice, 'Lord, do not hold this sin against them.' And when he had said this, he fell asleep." At his death, Stephen prayed. He cried out, "Do not hold this sin against them." Forgive. Forgive. Matthew 6:14. "For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." talk about a hard thing to hear and believe. If you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Grace does not appear to cover double standards. Matthew 7:2, for with the same judgment you pronounce, you will be judged, and with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Do not ignore your responsibility as a believer, a child of God. We are so close to His return. Do not fail so close to the prize. Forgive. Guard over your heart and forgive. Do not let frustration and anger and bitterness grow. Proverbs 4:23, guard your heart with all diligence, for from it flow springs of life. Philippians 4:8, finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think on these things. 1 Peter 2:12, conduct yourselves with such honor among the Gentiles that, though they slander you as evildoers, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day He visits us. Watch the news. In the American politics, the left is slandering the Christians. Whenever Muslims murder a dozen or more people in this country, the politicians immediately go to the defense of the Muslims and say, well, we're afraid of the Christian backlash against them, when the Christians have done nothing. They are slandering us as evildoers, when it is the Mohammedans who are murdering Christians. They, the deluded, the damned, will slander you as evil. We see this every day in the news as anti-Christians project and slander those who oppose them. This life on earth is not the life you are striving for. Matthew 6:19, lay not up for yourselves treasure upon earth, where moth and rust do corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust do corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Regarding the strong delusion, pray for those already in various forms of delusion. It may not be too late for them. Walk daily with forgiveness as your first thought when you encounter Satan's minions. For all of us, every last Christian, we were once as they are now. And by your walk, by your love, perhaps they will see Jesus as He should be seen, should repent, and be saved. 1 Peter 3:15, but in your hearts sanctify Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give a defense to everyone who asks you the reason for the hope that you have, but respond with gentleness and respect. Time is short, and the darkness is getting darker. So keep watch at all times, and pray that you may have the strength to escape all that is about to happen, and to stand before the Son of Man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.